Hello everyone, today I'm going to show you how to create parametric materials in Unreal Engine and how we can work with the instance material as well as the master material. So in the master material, whatever we set the parameters, we can change directly in the instance material also. So I'll show you how to create those materials in Unreal Engine 4.26. So let's start. Just first of all, just get your assets into your scene. And I have added this, and this is the my background. Now just go to the my stuff. This is the material panel, and here you see this is the textures. Now here I have added from another location, so directly you can drag and drop all the materials which you want. Now just go for the material, and just I'm creating a new material, right? And just I am putting the name master material, right? Is it you know, not required any space in between, so hit the enter once you complete the name. Just double click over the material, and after that you will get the material panel. Here you can adjust, you can create everything inside this material panel. This is the master material panel. Now just I'm docking over here. So this is the material testing, which is my main file. Now I'm just going to edit my material inside this area. Right click and drag. You can directly drag. If you want to zoom in, zoom out, then you can use scroll like this. Now in the right side you will get all the parameters which is useful for creating or modifying the material's attributes. So directly you can select the nodes from the right, or else you want to create from here, then press simply tab, then you can directly access all the nodes. If I want multiply, then I will say multiply. See. And again, if you say right click, then also you will get the same options. Here also you can access all the nodes which is inside this material panel. Okay. Now, this is the main material attributes. This is the shader part. Here we have to add all the maps inside these parameters. So first of all, just we have to go in the material testing folder. Here I have added a textures. Now select the textures which you want to add. It should be, you know, in a proper format, name format. First is, see, this is the base color, normal, roughness. Okay, so these three I'm just selecting and just drag it to in the material testing. This is my diffuse, and this is my the normal. So normal, it should be a bit below. I'm just putting here, and this one will be the roughness. Just connect with all the parameters. Like this is the base color, so RGB, connect with the base color. Again use this, this is the rough. Just click and drag to roughness, and this is the normal. As we know, it will, you know, gives you the highly detailed object. Now you can see, just I'm going to apply this because I'm going to check the material. Now you can see, this is the, you know, bigger size of UVs here. So just you want to coordinate, you want to adjust, or you want to give the tiling option, you want to apply here. So just we have to apply the few nodes right here. First of all, we need to get the texture coordination, texture coordinate. Again just we have to work with, you know, the multiplication thing. So just I'm going to add the multiply like this. Here now also we have to add the value of in it. So just connect this to A, and this should be in all the UVs. So I'm just going to scale all the UV values. So I'm just connecting this in this UVs. Again, just I'm going to add the value. So just here you will get a node that is constant. Select content node and add it to here. Just connect with the B. Right now you can adjust the value, then you will get this value of the condition. Now you can see I have scaled all the parameter of UVs. So now just I'm going to add another values in this. So already I have scaled the value. Just you want to decrease, also you can decrease, but just you have to save it first. If you apply, then you will get the result instant here. Yes, now it is scaled. Once it is done, then just add a color over this material. Now go to again the parameter panel, node panel. Here you will get the constant. As I said, this is constant, but constant 3 vector you have to select. Here you can see the RGB values. So here just you have to adjust the color value and say yes. Add a multiply node, tab multiply node. Yes. Now connect with this RGB V, and here just connect this one to A, right? And output goes to again the base color. If you say this is my color overlay which I have added here, yes, you want to change the color, just hit double click over the constant color. If you say blue, then it will adjust the color according to the value of this constant color. If you say yes, and just apply it. Now you can see I have added the color over these maps. So now just I want to check the parameters. So for the parameter I'm going to set the normal the parameter. In this particular area here we have to add another node, that is flatten normal. Flatten normal, just add it. And also here also you have to add the value. Just connect with this again in the normal. Now just I want to adjust the value of normal, then just again have to add the constant value. Drag it to here and connect with this flatness. It is by default you get in the 0. You want to adjust, you can, but right now just I want to convert into the parameter first. Right click, say over here, it is already converted, but now this value just I want to adjust, then I'll just convert into the parameter. Here we can adjust the size. We want to adjust the size of partition, so right click, just convert into the parameter, and here we can set UV size. This is the texture coordination which we don't require. Now just save it. Now we have already set all the parameters. Now just move into the material testing project. Here we can say just drag this material to the background. Yes, if it is done, go to the material testing panel. Here you can see the value of all these things which already we have applied here. You can see all the coordination which is right here. I'm just going to make another material which will be the instant material, instance material. just create a material instance and say okay, because this is my instant material. Just double click over here, you will get few of the parameter which we have already set. So go for the size. If you check on, then you can increase the value of this. So this is the normal value. I think already we have given different name. Okay, so no problem. Yes, UV resize. Yes, so this is the resize of our map. We can increase the tiling values from here, and this is not the size, this is the normal size. Yes, so you can increase the detailing of this particular. Normal map. So we can increase using these parameters. No, just I want to convert all the parameters into separate parameters. So go for again the testing material. Here also we can convert everything. Now this is the value of parameters. I have to change the name. Just right click. Comment also you can give, but just I want to change the name here. This is the normal. Select this and just change the parameter. Normal. Hit enter, you can see. If you save this, you will get the instant result out there. Yes. Now just I'm going to add another value of the roughness. Go to the switch, static switch. Where is static switch? Yes, parameter. I'm just adding is metallic. Yes, if it is yes, then okay. Again, just add the constant value. Again, I'm going to add the parameter of constant. Here again just we have to add with this false value, and again just connect with this true value and just connect this to a roughness. It is already parametric. If you save once, then it will show you in the direct project testing menu or in the material. Yes, if it is done, save it and go for the instant material. Here you can say, or you can see, this material is metallic. Now you switch on and you can check the value of the metallic. You can switch on or switch off. Just convert into the parameter. Right click. Convert to parameter. There also we can change the color and just connect this again, convert into parameter. Now it is the diffuse value. This one is the roughness. Convert to parameter. I'm just saying roughness. Here also we have another one, that is the normal. Convert to parameter and I'll say normal. Normal roughness, and this one is metallic. Sorry, we have to again just give the name change metallic. Again, we haven't added the metallic value. Actually, it was the diffuse. So I'm just again changing the name, and I will add the again one parameter, that will be the metallic. Metallic thing will come with this. So I'm just going to add with the metallic value and connect with metallic, because this would be with the metallic. And again I'm going to add another parameter, that will be the roughen value. So just click this and change to metallic, saying Ctrl plus W, so that you can make a duplicate of it. And connect with this roughness. Again I'm just connecting with this to UVs. Right. Now it's done. Now here we have to change, connect the parameter, change the name. This is the rough. We have all the parameters. So save it and go for the material, master material instance. There you can see all the parameters, and we can change the maps inside. Check on, then you will able to change the metallic value also. So this is the parametric. Here we can change all the types of materials or textures inside this parametric material. Now here we can see if we have different materials, different textures. So these are the examples of different materials. So I'm just going to use all these to our material section. Click this, drag here, and you want to change the diffuse. This is the wooden, create wooden. This one is the base color, so just I'm putting here. And the wooden metallic, this is the metallic, and this is the occlusion, but I have not added here, so just ignore it. And this is the normal. Yes, if you have the roughen area, then you can select the roughness also. Yes, now just save it. You can check or you can see the material. Now here we can see this is my different material, and here also you want to change the color parameter also, you can change. See, this is the color parameter. I'm changing this to different. Let's switch on. This is the RGB values. If you click here, you can check. So this is the different material. Now just I'm going to add, or I'm just going to import the asset into this thing. I have this wooden crate. Oh, no problem. Just import all. I do not want to add the materials, so do not create the material nodes and local. Okay, no problem. Import. Ignore it and just clear. Close it. Now you can see here, if I'm adding here this object and just using this material, now very nice material we have created for this. Now you can see the details. Now you want to adjust or normal map. just click the value directly